Today, I want to show you a tool that I find really handy. It's probably the most used tool out of a series of tools, but this particular tool is a tool I use on a weekly basis for taking notes on YouTube videos. Not only does it do that, but it also allows me to timestamp YouTube videos so I can potentially use it on my own content or content on clients. So this tool has a lot of great features. So we're gonna jump right in. And the tool I'm talking about today is the TubeSpanner Notes tool. Now, to get the TubeSpanner Notes tool, you're gonna need the TubeSpanner Chrome extension or Firefox or Edge, whatever browser that you use. What you wanna do is go and download the TubeSpanner extension. And then once it's running on your YouTube, you should have a floaty window like this one down here. But you can see at the top here, I'm on a watch page of a video. This happens to be a live stream from earlier today. If I want to do notes or timestamps or anything like that, I want to just like click on this little tab here. It says add notes. And you can see that this little window, which actually floats, I can actually move it around as well. But I'm going to leave it over here because I find it runs well when you've got like the video on the screen next to you. Straight away, what it does is it populates the video title straight from down here from the watch page. And then you have this note section and you can do things up here. Auto means if you put it in auto mode, it's gonna like play the video. This is particularly good for VODs. If it's a live stream, I just leave it on play because you want the live stream to play. Now you can go back to a different point. You can like pause, start, stop, and go backwards. Even in a live stream, you can roll back if you miss something to get the exact timestamp. If you're looking to like take notes on a very specific point, like you're doing actual timestamps. But if you're just generally taking notes, it's useful for that as well. So anytime you get into this, now I'm gonna maybe jump forward to, this is Chantel's stream from earlier today. Today she's talking about polls and doing polls on live streams. And so I might come along and decide that somewhere along here, there's going to be a timestamp. So she's talking about polls and she's showing some things here. So say at this point, I want to take some notes. So what I want to do is I come down into here. Now I can just start typing straight away. And what it's going to do, I'm going to write social stream ninja. You can see what it does. As soon as I start typing, it notes the exact timestamp of the video where I start typing. And then once it's done, I usually just come over here and hit the X and you can see it works and it adds it to this notes list. Now I might jump ahead or as I'm watching, I'm looking at something else. There's another one here that's getting shown off, which is straw poll. So I'm just going to pause it there. Sometimes you can just pause it. So what I'm going to do is hit return to lock in the timestamp. Then I can listen for a moment to the video to sort of formulate in my head what I want to write down here. And I might, for me, I'm just, for the demo, I'm just going to write straw poll demo. And then I'm going to lock that in. And then you can keep going through the video, throughout the video, and just keep noting notes. It'll automatically add the timestamp for you. There's a few things that you can do along the way. So I'm just going to let this video play a little bit. Maybe we'll move forward to a point in the future. I just want to have some timestamps for demonstration purposes. So I'm just going to hit into here and write timestamp for demo. I'm just making up random ones now. Yeah, so you can continue on. I'm just going to maybe lock in on that screen share there. I'm just going to stop that just to show you some of the other things that are happening here in the TubeSpanner Notes tool. Now, while I'm playing, instead of using the controls over here like I have been, I can actually use some controls up here. Once I get this started, say I start there. If I have it on auto and then I go to type a note, say I want to say results. What it's doing there is while I'm typing, it's pausing so that I can write the note without it continuing on. But often for me, I'd like to keep listening as I'm typing. I don't want to stop and start. But stopping and starting is a very good thing you could do if you're doing like a replay or a VOD where you don't need to be kept up to date with like say a live stream where you can pause, take notes and then continue without missing anything. And so as soon as I lock that note in, see it starts playing again. So that's what the auto does. Yeah, generally I keep mine on play. Now, save is just a button where you can actually just hit it to quickly back up what you've already done. But usually every time you lock in a timestamp, it saves that in place. Now, focus, what that does, if you turn that on, it takes away everything else around the video. So if I move this notes thing, it's grayed out all the other YouTube features there. So it lets me focus on the video. If that's something that you need, then you can turn focus on and off. Now, down here, I can also click this here to edit the title. So I don't like Chantel's title. I want to put a different title. And what if I want to change YouTube to live stream in the title? So I'm going to do that. I'm going to hit enter. And you can see now at the top there, it says your live stream audience. I can technically edit the notes in the same way down here. I can also remove notes. Say that I did note number 3 in error. Or I want to redo it, the timestamp's wrong, I can actually delete it, then roll back and then go back and find that spot and then record that spot. Now, the one thing you can't do is manually put in timestamps. So you want to make sure that you're hitting the return to lock it in or whatever at the right point. If you're doing a VOD, of course, you can control that. If it's a live stream, you might be wanting to try and stay up to date. You might find you may have to roll back if you've missed something and then get caught up. Along the way, it just depends on your use case for this. Now, what can you do with all this? Say I've got a bunch of timestamps in here. What can I do? The key thing at the end is what I always do is I go down the bottom here, export as chapters. When I click that, it's going to instantly give you a file. This is the file it gives you. I'm just going to double click on that. You get a text file, basically. It has the title of the video. It has always starts with the 000 because it's what YouTube requires is the first timestamp in a list of for chapters, you need to have a 000. Now, by default, TubeSpanner is going to put start a video, but generally you want to put something more descriptive than that. So what I usually do is take the top one and copy that down to the 000 start point. So it never says start of a video. Now, that's what I do if I'm using it for timestamps, to add timestamps to a live stream replay, or to if I'm manually going through and doing my own timestamps on my just upload video that hasn't gone live yet, it's unlisted and I'm just doing all my prep, I can use the notes feature in TubeSpanner to create my timestamps / chapters. And so I can save all that and upload that to YouTube, put it in the description field. I usually, if I'm ever putting chapters in a description field, I'm always going to write down the bottom and dropping them in there. You don't need to put the header chapters or anything. You just need to make sure the first one is 000 and then all the timestamps follow in sequence and you have at least 3 of them and they need to be at least 10 seconds apart between each one. Little catch up there on what chapters is all about on YouTube. If you want a fresh dedicated video on that, I have covered that before on my video. If you want to go back, maybe check the video out up here in the cards. I've covered chapters before when they first came out. Okay, so you can do all that. You can also, let's get rid of that. You can also use a view all notes, which is this one here. And this is where it gives you a bit more of a summary of all the notes that you've ever taken for different videos. These are the different videos and live streams that I've taken notes for myself and for clients. You can go back, click add notes to go back to the add note screen. The little arrow here is just like a minimization. So if you want to pop it down, you can minimize it. And then you can go close notes. That'll close that box totally. Now, those notes aren't just useful here on YouTube. It is now saved to my TubeSpanner channel. And you can actually look at that in TubeSpanner. So if I'm going to click on the dashboard, we're going to have a look at that real quick. Here I am on the TubeSpanner dashboard, on the TubeSpanner webpage, logged into my particular account. You can see up the top here, it says my recent projects. There's the video that I just timestamped. There's Chantel's video. There's some other videos across here that have timestamps and different things. Now, if I go to notes and chapters down here, meshes tools, you can also find it under, I believe, extras, notes and chapters, because it may not be in your meshes tools if you haven't used it before. And then you can see all the videos on YouTube that I have ever done. So I've done quite a few because I've got 9+ pages of these. I do these pretty much every week, clients and so forth. So I'm using this tool on a highly regular basis. So here I can access back to the original video. So if I ever want to go back to it, one that I've done before, instead of trying to find it on YouTube, which I can do it that way, I can also come in here and go open video on YouTube and it'll open up. I can delete everything. So delete it from my history, because once I've recorded it, it's here. It's created today. Everything's here. And I can still come across and export those same chapters like I did directly from the TubeSpanner extension. Now, they are in a little bit of a different order. They've got the timestamps on this side and the notes on this side. You can do whatever you like with these at this point, but this is like a record. So you've got these recorded for the duration. So you've got a history of it. You can go back. If you took notes on a video, you're going to maybe make a follow-up later on. You want to go back and look at your notes or notes history for that particular video because you want to refresh yourself. Then you can come in here. It is going to be in here. You can even do, there's even searching, which is so cool. Everything is in here. Every part of your notes and chapters history that you use the TubeSpanner tool for is in here, and you'll be able to jump in and do all the things. Let me know if you think this is a handy tool, that you, something that you might use, whether it's for chapter creation, timestamp creation, or just for taking basic note taking with a note as to where in the video that information is. I think this is a pretty cool tool. This is the tool that I use the most out of the whole suite of TubeSpanner tools. And there are a huge amount of tools, and there's more coming to the TubeSpanner family. You can see here, TubeSpanner, you can get the extension on these platforms. I don't believe that Safari is out yet, but some of these other ones should be, Chrome, Firefox, Edge. There are features beyond the extension, but the extension does a lot of things that you can do right in YouTube itself. So if you go back to YouTube and we have this little bar here, there's a whole bunch of things we can access, including our dashboards. So right here, if you look at it in the extension itself, you've got a whole bunch of things that you can access. There's milestone achievements, gives you a basic dashboard of information, and then some tools you can dive into. They have a thing called Toolbox, which has a lot of AI tools, including title inspiration, script generator, that you can go through, creating thumbnails, promotion and scheduling. You can do a lot of like nuts and bolts admin for your channel here. Smart descriptions, there's a whole bunch of things in here. And then you can go beyond that. There's an upload assistant that you can use to upload your video. If you want to dedicate a video on that, let me know. Social sharing, awesome stuff. A calendar, like a content calendar planner, very good. A dedicated built-in AI, which is basically you can ask a lot of things and it's going to know a lot about your channel because of it's linked your TubeSpanner account to your channel. It's already like scanned my channel here and it's talking to me. The AI is called Kim. And then there's information about your membership in the end of the column. But of course, get everything like I showed you before over on this, the YouTube dashboard, where you can access a lot more things. And I know there's a lot more coming out, which is I can't talk about right now, but you'll hear about it very soon. This is Future Doug here. And there is something else I can share. Just came out in the last day or two from when I'm recording this update. And it is a bonus feature. So jump over onto the screen here. You can see, first of all, with the TubeSpanner extension, we've got all the usual information here, but there's one extra little button here. It's called Home Run. We're going to click on this. And we've got a suite of new tools here that is all about optimization, search. This is like the brand new tool. Now, if you look over on the actual TubeSpanner website, it's actually under beta tools, home run. So if you're looking to optimize your videos, the new tools are here and you'll be looking for this home run. And this is sort of an idea of what you can do. Brand new feature just come out on TubeSpanner the last couple of days. So make sure you check out. Even more reason to grab a copy of TubeSpanner. So if you want to check out that feature, download the Chrome extension, you can go ahead and do that straight away. that if you want to sign up for TubeSpanner or even get a trial, then make sure you jump on over to TubeSpanner. I'll have a link in the description, and it's probably showing on the screen right now, maybe even a QR code, to let you know about TubeSpanner. You can give it a go for free and check it out. And then you can also sign up after the free trial for some of their plans. There's no contract, you're not locked in. You can go month to month, or you can pay an annual plan, maybe save some money by doing that. So if you want to, go check out TubeSpanner. More features than just the notes tool. The notes tool is the one I use the most. I like it. That's why I'm showing it to you today. But if you want to check out all the features, then why not try one of the free trials? I think that's the best way to go. Unlock that free trial, get in, check it out. And if you like it, I encourage you to sign up. Now, I've talked about different tools in the past. I'm going to be talking about a lot more soon. Maybe some live streaming tools, maybe some more of these channel help tools, growth tools, and tools that just help you be more efficient with your scripting. Then go check out this video playlist right here, where I've got some of those ready for you to watch, and be on the lookout for more. Well, this is Doug, and I'll catch you later.